guys, welcome back to my channel. So this week is Cleft Awareness Week. It runs from the 2nd to the 10th of May, and I thought I'd do some videos explaining what a cleft is, or just a few cleft related videos to celebrate it. So I'm on TikTok and I saw a whole account with a cleft baby, and I saw some comments on one of the videos where people just were uneducated. They don't know what a cleft is. Or they don't realize, you know, the extent of it. So some people were commenting things like, what is that hole? Or things like that. And while they don't mean it in an offensive way necessarily, you know, it does kind of sound a little bit derogatory. Another comment that I saw was someone saying how beautiful the baby was and that they didn't need any surgery because they were beautiful the way they were. And while that is a lovely thought, I fully support, you know, saying you're beautiful the way you are. For someone with a cleft, it's quite important that they get it repaired because there can be consequences to do with feeding, obviously bullying, but it can complicate a lot of things in their life that most people take for granted. Even when you've had your cleft repaired, there are still things that people who don't have a cleft would not realize that we go through. So if you didn't get it repaired, it would be quite a difficult life, and in some countries where kids are malnourished, it does lead to, unfortunately, death. So today I'm going to talk about clefts and what they are, because I think it's important for people like that and for people in general to understand clefts better, or if they don't know what it is, to learn about it, because it's really nothing to be afraid of, it's nothing to be ashamed of, and yeah, it's just, it happens. So let's dig in. So first off, what is a cleft? Well, a cleft is a separation or an opening in either the roof of the mouth or the lip or both. The cleft is basically the result of your facial features not fully coming together, not closing. So when the baby's in the womb in the early stages of pregnancy, it's just basically an incomplete development of facial features. When the face is forming in the womb, the top and the two sides are developing at the same time and growing together towards each other, and then they fuse in the middle, so that's about 4 to 6 weeks gestation. And that's the lip and the primary palate. At about 9 weeks, it's the secondary palate. 1 in 700 babies are born with a cleft, so it's common enough, but it's still, like, growing up, I didn't know that many other kids with a cleft. By the way, I realized that in this video I did not mention I have a cleft. I've talked about it in other videos, but if you're new here and you're wanting to learn about clefts, I myself was born with a cleft. I'm going to go on to talk about different types of clefts and I'll tell you which one I had. But yeah, basically I've gone through it. There's ongoing research as to why this happens. We still don't know why it happens. It can be hereditary, so there's a chance that when I have kids they could potentially have a cleft, but it's not, it's like, it's hard to know. They're still researching it. But I have definitely seen, and I know of, mothers who've had a child with a cleft. I've been on medical missions with the charity Operation Smile, so I've seen it. But also there is a UK mum who has a cleft, who has a baby. Check her out on Instagram. It's Don't Get Lippy UK, and she does lots of cleft content. But yeah, it can be hereditary. They've done research with bats and kind of found a link with bats, but it's still up in the air as to exactly why it happens. So there are various types of clefts, and today we're just going to focus on cleft conditions rather than craniofacial conditions as a whole, because I have obviously more experience in the cleft department, and we'd be here all day if we were talking about every kind of craniofacial condition out there. I'm sure there's loads of information on all that should you wish to look into it further. For example, in the movie Wonder, there's a little boy who has Treacher-Collins syndrome, which is a craniofacial condition. But like I said, we're just gonna cover clefts today. So like I said, there's a few different types of clefts, and I'm gonna go through them now and explain what I have. You can have just the lip, you can have just the palate, you can also have both on one side, or both on both sides. So yeah, there's quite a few different variations, and it's different for everyone. Not everyone who has a cleft has the same experience. If it's on one side, it's unilateral, like myself. If it's on both sides, it is a bilateral cleft. There's also a microformed cleft, which I talked about in my Wendy Williams video, which I'll link below or put up here. And yeah, that's basically when they've been born with the scar rather than the lip not completely closing, it closed but it left a scar. So here's some stats that I found on the CLAPI website, which is the Cleft Lip and Palate Association of Ireland. Here are just some percentages that were taken quite a couple of years ago. I think it was 1998. 50% have cleft lip and palate, and then about 30% palate only and 20% lip only. So it would seem that the majority would have both, like cleft lip and palate, CLP. So of course, like I said, there are a couple of surgeries that go with being born with the cleft. And the first one is when you're about 3 or 4 months. I think I had mine at 3 months, and that's the lip. So they do that first, and then between 6 and 12 months, you'll have your palate repair. And I think I was about 6 months, more or less. There's also orthodontic care, which basically is most of your life. And I mean, I don't have any ongoing treatment, but I have to wear a retainer basically for the rest of my life, because even if I don't wear it for, like, if I forget to wear it for a little while, I can feel that my teeth have moved. And it's been years since I got my braces taken off. So yeah, it's basically for the rest of your life. When I was little, I had continuous checkups with my team, which I'll talk about in a minute. I had continuous dental appointments in St. James's Hospital. And then as I got older, I started having orthodontic treatment. So you get that about 9, 10. I can't remember exactly what age I was when I started that. But it was around then, because when I was 11, I had a bone graft. So you have a bone graft shortly after you start your orthodontic treatment. So yeah, around 10, 11, 12, around that age, I think, is when you get your bone graft, which is basically if you're missing some bone up in your palate. So they took some bone from my hip and put it in my palate. I think I may have talked about this before in a cleft video in the past, but yeah, I got some bone missing in my hip, and it's up in the roof of my mouth, which might sound a bit strange, but that's what they do. And for those of you wondering, yes, it is kind of like, it is plastic surgery, but it's not cosmetic. None of it is cosmetic. So while we are getting plastic surgery to fix the lip and the palate, all that, it's the nose as well. You can get further treatment done to your nose. It's not actually cosmetic as much, it's more functional. You need to be able to eat properly and breathe properly and all that kind of stuff. So it's, yeah, it's quite important. Not saying that cosmetic surgery is not important. If it's important to you, that's up to you. But it's very different. It is plastic surgery, but it's vital to help you live an easier life. Like I said, you can have further surgeries later on, so to your nose or whatever. And basically, the orthodontic treatment stops about 18 years old, and so do the team checks. Like I said, you have a team. So the team is basically made up of a plastic surgeon, a maxillofacial surgeon, an ENT surgeon, an orthodontist, a speech therapist, and yeah, speech and language therapist, that's it. So that's the team, and I met with them once a year growing up. And I actually didn't have my last checkup because I was in transition year that year, and they never scheduled another one, so I never had my last one. But I had one more recently because I had a few questions about something. So that's kind of the basics of what a cleft is and what the steps are to repairing and correcting the teeth and all that kind of jazz. But yeah, that's all the steps that you go through. Some people have, like I said, every cleft journey is different, but we can all relate to each other in, obviously, we have, you know, we have similar things, we go through the same thing. But some people do have a different journey. Some people have way many more surgeries. I had 3. I had the 2 when I was a baby, and then the 1 when I was 11. Some people have more, some people have less. It's different for everyone, but we have that one thing in common. And if you do see someone with a cleft or a baby with a cleft online, basically if you're gonna comment anything, just make sure that it's, you know, make sure that if someone said it to you, you wouldn't be offended. I'm going to talk about this in another video, some terminology and things like that, but yeah, just make sure that you're being kind to everyone, and happy Cleft Awareness Week. Now, hopefully you know more about clefts and what it's all about. If you haven't already, please do subscribe. I post about lots of different types of content, but I do post some cleft related videos because it is a cause close to my heart, and obviously I've been through it, so I might as well share my story and share what I know. I'd love for you to join the family if you haven't already here on YouTube. I'm getting close to 200 subscribers, so I'd love for you guys to help me get there. That would be amazing. But this video is not about that. It's about, obviously, spreading awareness about clefts. And yeah, like if you want to see more cleft content, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye!